Welcome back to American Latino TV. I'm your host, Natasha Martinez. Up next, we catch up with two-time Grammy Award winning producers, Play-N-Skillz. The brothers Juan Play Salinas and Oscar Skillz Salinas are of Argentinian and Venezuelan descent and grew up in Dallas, Texas. While attending high school, Play-N-Skillz began to pursue their childhood passion of DJing, starting in their bedroom and eventually graduating to house parties and nightclubs. Soon after, the brothers built a makeshift recording studio in their mother's bathroom and began to teach themselves music production. The rest, as they say, is history, as Play-N-Skillz are now one of the hottest music producing duos in Latin pop, recently scoring major hits with the likes of Becky G, Leslie Grace, and Frankie J. And now they drop down to share their amazing story right here on American Latino TV.
My government name is Juan Carlos Salinas. Stage name is Play.
Oscar Salinas.
And it's Skillz. We're a DJ, producer, artist group. You know, we grew up in a Section 8 in a town called Irving, Texas, on the south side. Predominantly black neighborhood, which actually inspired our hip-hop roots. But our house was like straight Latino, which kind of fused, you know, who we became later in life. I literally was just watching a guy by the name of DJ Scribble on this show called The Grind, DJing. And, you know, he's an Italian guy with a tattoo. He looked cool. And
he we thought he was Latino.
Yeah, right? Yeah, I did. And I was like, hey, he kind of looks like what we could be. And I got inspired because he just had control of this crowd, and I wanted to be a DJ. So I went and bought a DJ in a box, which is the beginner starter kit. I think like in high school, we started getting popular within the neighborhoods of DJing because we started throwing house parties. House parties turned into renting ballrooms. And we started making a little bit of money so we could buy equipment. Then, you know, artists started coming to us for production and remixes. And we got our first big break with a guy by the name of Little Flip, Texas legend. He gave us a shot to produce his album, which ended up being the number one hip-hop album that year. And it was our first platinum album. We got a publishing deal, and, you know, it just exploded for us. Our latest single is called Si Una Vez. Well, we have two different versions. We have the Spanish version, which is Frankie J, Leslie Grace, and we sing. It's a Selena cover. So we just try to give a facelift to an incredible song that was already done by an incredible, legendary artist, and we're just blessed to even be able to associate ourselves with Selena. And then we have the English version, which is somewhat of a translation that we did with Becky G, who we've been working on her album producing, and Cap G, who's an up-and-coming young Latino Mexican rapper from Atlanta. Marchate, ya no me llames, piérdete, y no me busques, ya lo sé, quererte no valió la pena, sola, solita te quedas. And at the time, Lil Wayne was arguably the best rapper in the world. You know, you're supposed to get a production fee when you're a record producer up front, and then the song sold millions of singles. It was huge, but where's the money? We tried to do things right, and you know, we went to court, and it was a big headline. And you know, I think a lot of it had to do sometimes with like us being Latino in a predominantly black owned space. I think they just thought we were just gonna sit down and lay down. And I wanted to let them know and anybody know that, you know, we're doing business the right way. And if not, then you will see from us. A few years back, when we had a record deal at Universal Records, at the time, reggaeton exploded, you know. And us being Latinos, they just were executives. Just, hey, follow the wave. But we were like, nah, it's not what we're doing right now. You know, at that time, we were really into hip hop. And if we hadn't gone the route of like producing all the urban music, electronic music, then I don't think we'd get the respect that we're now garnishing on the Latino side. A lot of the artists on the Latin side are willing to work with us because we worked with everybody else. From David Guetta to, like we said, Lil Wayne and Daddy Yankee. I mean, that's three of the biggest artists in their genre of music. And we're still proud Latinos doing it.